This is now the center of all those eye-popping developmental forces that our fathers and forefathers gave the Western region, gave Nigeria, and gave Africa. Here, even in pre-colonial and post-colonial Nigeria, we earned our regards in the art of the world. Let me welcome you to a matter that I have conveniently labeled the intellectual capital of Nigeria. You may recall that Ibadan was of the first university in Nigeria and became the conference of virtually all the scholars in Nigeria and even Africa. The Chris Okigbos, the Jubilee Aminos, the Wole Soyinkas, all cut their intellectual teeth on this soil. This land became the incubator of intellectuals in Nigeria, and most professors of renown anywhere in the country had their intellectual umbilical cords cut here in the early soil of Ibadan. Distinguished leaders of our great party, the All Progressive Congress, APC, my brother governors and their representatives, let me welcome you once again to the city that the great writer J.P. Clark said was running splash of rust and gold, that is strong and scattered. I'm sure that on your way down here, you had a taste of J.P. Clark's Ibadan. It is our unique trajectory that makes us a different people under the sun. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, like everything bright and beautiful, however, our land suffered great assaults after the demise of those brilliant minds who brought developmental milestones to our land. The previous 8 years in particular, before our own, was specifically renowned for the destruction of all those bright and beautiful things that we celebrated. In the hands of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, our state went to the dogs, and the dogs, unable to contain the shame, threw Oyo State to the swine. Permit me to be modest in it. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, in the last 1,000 days or thereabout, however, we have redefined the concept of governance so much that the last time our state witnessed similar milestones was during the reign of our late sage, Chief Obafemi Awolowo, and later by our own Chief Gbolahi. We have brought back the elusive piece that developmental scientists say is the precondition for development. Before now, you are all aware of how bloodletting was the father of the day in Oyo State. Today, with the help of the Almighty God and the sagacity that comes with our pedigree, violence and brigandage have become a thing of the past now. We have gone a notch higher by building on this platform of peace and infrastructural revolution that is unprecedented in the history of the land. From the ashes of a city notorious in reputation as the second dirtiest in Nigeria, we are building a metropolis that is conducive for business and investment. The resultant effect is that investors are platforming on this mileage to bring their businesses to Oyo State. Gradually, we are becoming a preferred destination for investors and those who seek a conducive atmosphere to engage the brain and intellectual discourse. Your presence here today, distinguished leaders, ladies and gentlemen, is undoubtedly a huge deposit in our intellectual bank account. It also confirms that our transformation from a land of violence to a place to be. When this state was about to war zone, we had thugs, brigands, abetted by a government in power. We had derailed. Oyo State could never have been the choice of a gathering as this. Let me salute the courage and the initiative of our leaders for this meeting, APC Governors Forum Lecture Series. What distinguishes our party from others is our preference for the intellect and belief in profound scientific solutions to the problems of a plural people. Our decision to brainstorm on the national challenge of unemployment at this forum underscores our belief that a mental and intellectual approach to problems will dissolve the challenge into nothingness in no long a time. Let me state that the problem of unemployment is no doubt a global one, touching many countries in varying degrees. The most important consideration, however, has been how each country responded to the challenge of unemployment. Nigeria's unemployment rate is spiraling upwards, growing at 16% per year. The youth of the nation are the most impacted by this problem, with a youth unemployment rate of over 50%. In the past 6 years, an average of 2 million people entered the job market, showing the declining rate of job creation in the economy, fueling the massive joblessness in the economy. According to the National Bureau of Statistics, while employment rate was 5.8% in 2008, in 2009, it was 11.8%. And at the last count, as at 2012, it was 23.9%. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we must do something urgently as a nation to reverse this undesirable trend. We must be attentive to the alarm raised by one Jim Adams, who warned that of all the aspects of social misery, nothing is as heartbreaking as unemployment. And former American President Bill Clinton also added the Philip to the need to address the problem of unemployment. And according to him, he said, we can only address the need to repair the basic fabric of society when people willing to work have work, because work organizes life. It gives structure and it gives discipline to life. What we in APC are doing through this lecture series is to provide a platform for leadership. We must realize, in the words of my guide, that governance and leadership are the yin and the yang of successful society. If you have leadership without governance, you risk China. Rather, you risk time running, fraud, and personal fiefdoms. If you have governance without leadership, you risk atrophy, bureaucracy, and indifference. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, That is what we are witnessing to. In taking this discursive and intellectual approach to the challenges of our nation, we are also telling the world that when we eventually take over the reign of governance at the federal level come next year, we will provide those who believe me, can you give a standing round of applause? Those who don't believe this statement should please leave the room. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, when we take over the reign of governance at the federal level come next year, we will provide a more proactive and knowledge-driven solution, not only to the problem of unemployment, but the gamut of challenges plaguing this nation today. Once again, I want to welcome you all to our state, to Ibadan, the land of ancient warriors. Our people are renowned for their unmatched hospitality and friendliness that have lasted ages. Please, do avail yourselves of this hospitality and our hospitable disposition of our people. After this occasion, when you depart for the different destinations, we want you to go away with a feeling of having traversed the soil where architects, builders and engineers are busy at work, forging a modern state out of a state that was held promises but was held down by a swarm of locusts. The support of our people in this regard has been tremendous, and for this we are eternally grateful. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for this.